Hello children, welcome back to your English online class. I am your English teacher. Today in this video, I am going to explain the question answers of lesson number 1, Swami Vivekananda. So, children, listen the video and audio very clearly and read it very carefully. I hope you all understood the lesson. Swami Vivekananda already we explained in our previous video. So, today in this video, I am going to explain the question answers of this lesson. Yes, first come to the glossaries of this lesson. The glossaries of this, glossaries means the difficult words meaning which are very unknown or this one. The first one is spirituality. Spiritual means dharmika vyakti. In English, the spirituality means the concept of being good human being. The next, second one. Dedicate. The answer is devotee. Kannadadalli arpisu. Third is desire. That is wish. Kannadadalli asegalu. Fourth, earnest. It means serious. That is shraddha purvakavagi kelsa madavu. Next, fifth one. Wandering. Going from one place to another. Wandering andra oddha jagana innond jagakke aledaaduvudu. Next, sixth one. Pleasure. That is happiness, khushi padevadu. Then seventh one, pride, a feeling or a deep pleasure from one's own achievements. Innobbara kelsa nodi namga khushi sigutala adu vikulin, that is a pride. The next one is tutor, that is a private teacher, one who teaches a single pupil or a very small group. That is, you all go for the tuition na? For that which is called as a tutor. Then ninth, passages, simply a portion or a section or a written word either in fiction or a non-fiction. That is, passages in a small portion which will be written in a fiction or a non-fiction one. Next one, tenth one, that is sympathy. That is, feeling of pity and sorrow for someone else's misfortune. Andra innobrumen daya terasudo, sympathy andra daya or kindness. Next comes 11th one, monks. That is a member of a religious community. That is a person who belongs to a religious community. That is sadhu oriental original and call them as a monks. The next comes embrace, 12th one. Is to welcome with the open arms. That is, we should welcome with the open arms. Khushi padavadu. 13th one, acceptance. That is to take or a receive. Tekkoludu. That's 14th one. Tolerance. Capacity to endure pain. That is, we should have a tolerance. Sahana Shakti. The next comes upliftment. To lift up or improve socially, culturally and normally. That is, to improve the social and normally of the people. The next comes 16th one. Essence. That is, quality or something. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದೇನೋ ಚಲೋ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಗುಣಗಳು, ಅದಕ್ಕೇನಂತಾರೆ ಎಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಾರೆ. ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಸಟಿಸ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫುಲ್ಫಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೀಡ್ಸ್. ಸಟಿಸ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಖುಷಿ ಪಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು, ಏನೇ ಒಂದು ಕೆಲಸ ಅಥವಾ ಯು ಫೀಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿನೆಸ್ ನ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸಟಿಸ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ 18th ಒನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಥಂಡರ್ ಅಪ್ಲಾಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಲೌಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎ ಡೀಪ್ ನಾಯ್ಸ್. ಥಂಡರ್ ಅಪ್ಲಾಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್, ಅಪ್ಲಾಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲಾಪ್. ಥಂಡರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಜೋರ್ಲೆ ಚಪ್ಪಾಳಿ ತರ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ದಿ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ಸ್ ಎ ಥಂಡರ್ ಅಪ್ಲಾಸ್. ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ 19, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯುಮ್ಯಾನಿಟಿ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಜನರಸ್ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಕೈಂಡ್ನೆಸ್. ದಟ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ವಿವೇಕಾನಂದ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯುಮ್ಯಾನಿಟಿ ಪರ್ಸನ್. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಜನರಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ 20, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ. ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡಿ ಬರುತ್ತೇವೆ, ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬರಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಈಕ್ವಾಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್, ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಕಮ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಚೂಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ರೋಪ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗಿವನ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹಿಯರ್. In that, you have to select any one which is the correct answer. See the first one. Swami Vivekananda established Belur Mata. Why he established Belur Mata? The options is, first one is A1. Make a people remember his speech in the Parliament of Religions. Next, second, to spread the principle of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa, then C, to develop human values, and D, social divisions. The answer is Swami Vivekananda established Belur Mata to spread the principles of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa. That the principle of Ramakrishna Paramahansa was work is worship. Yes, after coming in from Chicago, he established the Belur Mata to spread the principles of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa. Let's come. Second one, Swami Vivekananda acquired the knowledge of human values. Yes, how we acquired the knowledge of human values means whether first one from his parents, second one through his spiritual experience, third visiting countries, and D, all of the above. The correct answer is Swami Vivekananda acquired the knowledge of human values through his spiritual experience. Yes, through his spiritual experience, he acquired the knowledge of human values. Next comes third one. Narendra was born on, first one, September 11, 1893, B, January 12, 1863, C, September 11, 1863, D, 12 January 1893. Yes, the correct answer is Swami Vivekananda was born on 12 January 1863 in Kolkata. Where he was born? On 12 January 1863. Then to the last one, fourth one. The audience in the parliament of religious applauded Swami's speech because the first option is he spoke well. B, he addressed them as sisters and brothers of America. Then C, he spoke in English. Then D, his speech conveyed his humanism. Yes, the correct answer is the audience in the parliament of religious applauded Swami's speech because he addressed them as sisters and brothers of America. The answer is he addressed them as a sisters and brothers of America when he was participated in the World Religious Parliament in Chicago. He addressed them as sisters and brothers of America. Yes, next we'll come to the say true or false. Say whether the following statements are true or false. The first one, the audience in the parliament of religions did not accept speech of Swami Vivekananda. The answer is wrong. But the correct answer is the audience in the parliament of religion accepted the speech of Swami Vivekananda. Next, Swami Vivekananda was a wandering monk because he wanted to spread Hinduism. Here the answer is false. Here the Swami Vivekananda was a wandering monk, but he did not want to spread Hinduism, but he wanted to spread brotherhood and humanity. So he was a wandering monk. The next comes third. Swami Vivekananda worked for Universal Brotherhood. Yes, the answer is correct. He worked for the Universal Brotherhood. The next fourth one. The words of Narendra's mother, him become a wandering monk. False. Fifth one. Swami Vivekananda went to a Chicago as a political leader. Here the answer is wrong. The correct answer is Swami Vivekananda went to a Chicago as a spiritual leader to participate in the World Religious Parliament. The next comes sixth one. The Belur Mata was established before Swami Vivekananda went to Chicago. The answer is false. The Belur Mata was established after Swami Vivekananda came back from Chicago. Then it was established. The motto of Swami Vivekananda established the Mata was he wanted to spread the preachings of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa. That is work with worship. He established the Mata after coming from Chicago. The next comes question answers which I had given from the middle questions. See the first question one. Who was Swami Vivekananda? The answer is Swami Vivekananda was a spiritual leader. Yes, he was a spiritual leader. The next comes when he was born. That is Swami Vivekananda was born on 12 January in 1863 in Calcutta. He was born to a traditionally Bengali family in Calcutta. The next, who were his parents? His parents were Mother Bhuvaneshwari Devi and the father was Vishwanath Datta, who was a famous lawyer. The next, what is the early name of Swami Vivekananda? The answer is, the early name of Swami Vivekananda was Vireshwara, that is Lord Shiva. He was a boon of God Shiva, so they named him as a Vireshwara. Then next comes, who was the guru of Swami Vivekananda? The guru of Swami Vivekananda was Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. He was the guru who helped Swami Vivekananda to discover the truth. He got the correct answer from this guru only, that is Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Next, sixth one. At what age Swami Vivekananda went to school? That is, at the age of 6, Swami Vivekananda went to school where he learned the Sanskrit grammar and long passages from Ramayana and Mahabharata. He went to a private tutor also. Next, seventh one. What was the motto of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa mission? That is, motto means what is the main intention. The motto of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was work is worship, where you have to work is worship. Then comes the question answers from the lesson now. See the children here. First question, how is India described by the writer? So we already learned, understood in the lesson, the first paragraph, the writer described, see here. The answer is, India is described by the writer as a land of many religion and culture. People here take both pleasure and pain alike. They are dedicated and duty bound. In this land, many well-known religious leaders have been born. It means, you all know, India is a land of many religions and cultures. Here people take both pleasure and pain, means they share their sorrows and pains and they take happiness. They are dedicated and duty bound. In this land, many well-known religious leaders have been born. That is like Akka Mahadevi, Basavanna. These are all religious leaders who have born in this land. The next come to the question number second. What kind of a coachman did Narendra's mother want him to become? Yes, what was the wish of Narendra's mother? That is, Narendra's mother wanted him to become a coachman like Krishna who taught Arjuna. That is, his mother want to be a coachman like Krishna who taught Arjuna in Mahabharata. That is, he helped Arjuna to tell the Bhagavad Gita in Mahabharata. Then it comes to third one. Why did Narendra want to be a coachman? Here the answer is, Narendra want to be a coachman because he thought it was a nice to drive a coach. Next, fourth one. Why was Narendra named Vireshwara? The answer is, Narendra was named Vireshwara because their parents considered the child as the boon of God Vireshwara Shiva. So they named him as a Vireshwara when he was a child, because they were the very pious couple. They were considered the Vireshwara, the god Shiva. So the name him as a Vireshwara. See children, come to the next question number 5. Why was Narendra considered a wandering monk? You know, wandering means moving from one place to another. The answer is, Narendra went on and on, traveled all over the country to discover the truth. Narendra was kind to all. He had sympathy for the poor. He was courageous too. So these qualities in him become a wandering or a moving monk. That means Narendra went on and traveled all over the country to discover the truth. He was a very kind to all the people and he was a very sympathy for the poor people. And also he was a very courageous. Of these qualities, he became a wandering monk. Next come to the question number 6. What kind of education did Narendra advocate? Here the answer is, Narendra advocated that education should develop a complete human being. It means Narendra says that everybody should have a education. Through that we can have a complete human being. Next come to the next question. That is 7th one. What mayor of audience in the parliament of religion give a thunderous applause to Narendra? Yes, what happened in the parliament of religion when they gave a thunder applause to Narendra? What made him? The answer is, when Narendra began his address with brothers and sisters of America, immediately there was a huge thunder applause in the parliament of religions. That is, when Narendra went to participate in the world religious parliament in Chicago, when he began his speech, that is when he addressed the speech saying brothers and sisters of America, so immediately there was a huge thunder applause in the parliament of religions. Next, come to the question number 8. What helped Narendra earn respect and appreciation from the people of America? The answer is, Narendra told that everybody should develop a sense of brotherhood and love each other. So there was a great respect and appreciation from the people of America. Yes, in religious parliament, what he says that he should develop a, that everybody should develop a sense of brotherhood and love for each other. For this reason, he got a great respect and appreciation from the people of America. Okay, children, come to the last question. That is, did Narendra believe in superstitions? That is, superstitions means Moodanambikegalu. The answer is no. Narendra did not believe in superstitions. He always believe in work in worship. That is, we should believe in that only. Yeah, come to the fourth question. That is, writing. Complete the following table using the details given in the lesson on Swami Vivekananda. Here this list. Here are the some spelling mistakes in the Vivekananda. Just correct it, children. First one, the date of birth of Swami Vivekananda. That is 12 January 1863. Next comes name given by parents. That is Vireshwara. They gave him the name when he was child. That is Vireshwara, because the parents believed in the god Shiva. So they named him as a Vireshwara. Then next comes parents, that is mother, that is Bhuvaneshwari Devi, and father Vishwanath Datta. He was born in a traditionally Bengali family. The next comes characteristics of Swami Vivekananda. He was a good leadership, dedicated, duty bound, sympathy and courageous man. And next comes life mission. What was his life mission? Is to spread knowledge through education. The next comes unique achievements, what he had made the achievements in the life. That is, he founded the Belur Mata, made a speech in the Great Hall of Columbus in the Parliament of Religions, and next traveled all over the country to spread the knowledge, universal brotherhood. This is what Swami Vivekananda did in his life. Next comes language exercise, that is vocabulary. See here, children, fill the blanks choosing the right words given in the box. See here, in the box there are some words, that is spiritual, superstitions, earnest, despair and preach. Here's a small paragraph here. That is, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa is a very well-known spiritual leader. Yes, he was also the guru of Swami Vivekananda. Yes. Whenever people in despair is losing the all hopes, approached him, he would say that they must be earnest in their belief in the divine. Earnest means you should have serious, that is Shraddha irbeku, nimya avade Vishwas irbeku. He also used to preach saying that belief in superstition may not take anyone in the world. Yes. Andha Vishwasale nambabadu, adu nambidre nava munduke hogodilla anta Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa avaru helutare. This is what Ramakrishna Paramahansa says, that we should not believe in superstitions. Yeah, next comes substitute the following with one word. You can take the help of the choice given in the box. Substitute means giving only one word for one answer. Take for example, a man who stitches the clothes, we call him as a tailor. The man who cuts our hairs, we call him as a barber. Yes, the man who looks the garden, we call him as a gardener. In this way, here are some more examples you just see here on your screen. First one, a man who drives a coach, we call him as a coachman. The next, second one, one who believes in the existence of God, we call him as a theist. That is, who believes in the God, we call him as a theist. Next comes third, one who does not believe in the existence of God, we call him as a atheist. Next, fourth one. One who doubts the existence of God, we call him as an agonist. The last one. One who believes in serving of mankind, we call him as a philanthropist. Doing the social work, helping for the poor people, we call him them as a philanthropist. The next comes, use the following words in the meaningful sentences. Here are some words. You can make your own sentences. Here I have given us some examples here. First one, pride. That is, Taj Mahal is the pride of India. You can make another word also. Accept. He accepted my request. You can make the another sentence. Accept. My mother accepted my request also. You can write it. Next, also you can write, my friend accepted my gift also, you can write it. Experience, he has a good experience at teaching. You can also write, he has a very good experience in driving the car. Next comes dedicate, Mahatma Gandhi dedicated himself to India's freedom. Or you can write, Swami Vivekananda dedicated his entire life in helping the poor people also, you can write it. Then next come tolerance, one should have a tolerance towards their other religions. Tolerance means patience. Now come to the fourth question, children. That is, match the words in the list A with their opposites in the list B. You know, all of you, what you mean by opposite words. See here, in the A column and the B column. In the A column, that is strong. The opposite of strong is, that is weak. C. In the B column, and the answer is C. The next is despair, means losing your hopes. The correct answer is in the B column, that is A. Then next comes third one, good. The answer is evil. The next comes fourth, that is love. The answer is E, that is hatred. Then last comes life. The correct answer is D, that is death. This is what all we discussed today. Yes, I hope you all have understand this, all the question answers and everything. And I request all of you to write this question answers in your classroom book very neatly and correctly. And in the next video, I'll discuss about the grammar. I'll tell the basic grammar, what is alphabets, what is vowels and consonants, and we'll go for the sentences. Okay, today is enough in this lesson. Again, I tell you all of you to write this all the question answers in your class or book. Okay, children, bye and take care of yourself. Then I'll see in the regular classes. Okay, children, bye and take care.